Tips to learn Spanish quick. First of all, it's important to understand the difference between learning Spanish and speaking Spanish. Unfortunately, most people choose learning methods that only teach them the stuff of Spanish, grammar, vocabulary, etc., but don't actually allow them to practice talking. You can study for months and months with these methods, but when someone asks you a question in Spanish, you just freeze and discover that you can't actually speak. This is where a lot of people give up. The ideal way to learn is to make sure that you get the best of both worlds. Keep it simple and focus on one or two methods, while ignoring everything else. The ideal way to learn is to make sure that you get the best of both worlds. Pros: many apps are free, and it's super easy to get started. Apps and software have turned the learning experience into a fun game, rewarding you for your progress and sending you lots of reminders so that you don't slack off. Cons: apps teach you some vocabulary and a little bit of grammar, but that's about it. Most of the big companies say their app is scientifically proven to be effective, but in reality most of them are quoting the same researcher who they all paid to do a study on them. Pros: audio courses are a good way to get familiarized with the sounds of the language and get some basic phrases under your belt. With TV/movies/radio, you can listen to subjects that are interesting and relevant to you. Once you've reached a conversational level, listening is great for expanding your vocabulary and improving your comprehension skills. Cons: audio courses are extremely limited in the material they cover. TV/movies/radio need hundreds, if not thousands, of hours of exposure, and it's not very helpful for beginners who can't understand very much Spanish yet. Most people are tempted to just listen in the background while they're doing something else, i.e. driving to work, which makes them even less effective. Pros: a nice structured approach, you just need to show up and follow along. The teacher can explain concepts and answer your questions. Students in the class can motivate and help each other since you're all in it together. Cons: can be very expensive. You progress only as much as the slowest person in the class. Many people have taken Spanish in college and high school, but learned very little. Because of the number of people in a class, you could take a 3-hour class and then spend only 5 to 10 minutes actually speaking. Pros: a textbook is probably still best way to learn grammar. It's nice to have practically everything you need in one book, and just focus on that rather than trying to juggle 3 to 4 different methods. Read up on a concept and then do practice exercises until you fully understand it. Cons: it's old-fashioned and can be pretty boring on its own. You need to be very self-disciplined and be willing to study. If you don't understand a concept, you won't be able to get an explanation. Speaking Spanish. Pros: free. Practicing with a friend or family member can be less intimidating than with a stranger, and since they know you, they will be supportive and patient with you. Cons: your friend probably won't be able to explain the mistakes you make. Most native speakers don't know the rules of their own language, things just sound right to them. You may also find yourself reverting to English often because it's just easier. Pros: free. You get to meet people in your area, share learning tips with each other, and chances are someone in the group will know the answer if you have any questions. Cons: it can be intimidating if you're a shy person. Meetups are generally 10 plus people, and what can happen is that 2 to 3 more confident speakers will end up doing most of the talking, while shyer people will just sit and listen. Works better if you're already conversational. Pros: a professional teacher has comprehensive knowledge of grammar and can explain the differences between English and Spanish. They can coax even the shyest person into speaking, and help build your confidence and become a source of motivation. Cons: not free, but doesn't cost as much as most people think. It can also be time-consuming to find a teacher if you use an online teacher directory like Italki, where everyone is supposedly a 5-star teacher, but it can take several tries before you find a decent one. Rocket Spanish is especially good at getting results quickly because it focuses on giving you the important and essential language first. If you're heading to a Spanish-speaking country and you need a quick induction, you'll appreciate how quick this is. When you consider the number of tools you get, the effectiveness of the material and the low cost, Rocket Spanish is probably one of the best value interactive Spanish courses on the market at the moment. Click the link below to visit the Rocket Spanish website.